How many times have you seen somebody get a triple-double in game six in the deciding game to win the championship? I knew he was great, but I really seen greatness that day. What's up, world? This is Steven Jackson, and here's my story on greatness. The first time I encountered greatness, it was definitely experiencing playing with Tim Duncan. Being able to actually play in the finals and play with the best power forward to ever play the game. I think in the finals in 2003, game six, I think Tim Duncan's greatness was really overlooked that game. I knew he was great, but I really seen greatness that day. How many times have you seen somebody get a triple-double in game six in the deciding game to win the championship? For him to go out with having two blocks away from a quadruple-double, 20 points, 20 rebounds, and like eight blocks. Dominate the whole game from start to finish, demand double teams, and his stat line, just to see how dominant someone can be and his greatness. You know, I look at so many greats that finish their career without getting an NBA championship. So many guys come through, and a lot of guys come through and don't even care about it. They really care about the money and don't really care about being the champion. I only play to win, and that's something that me and Tim Duncan had in common. He wanted to win. He wanted to be a winner. He's always been a winner. He led more by his work ethic. He led more about being that guy that wins games. I respect the guy more who goes out there and get the job done and focused on winning games instead of talking about it. He's actually doing it. I would always rather be with a leader who's willing to lead by example and not just talk about it. And Tim Duncan embodies that. That's the reason why when you come to San Antonio, you have to come as a team player and understanding your role. When you see Pop get on Tim and when he makes a mistake and scream at him and curse him out just as he do the guy that doesn't play, you have to respect that. And Tim is one of those guys that he's not a superstar that feel like he can't get coached. He's not coachable. Pop can scream at him and teach through Tim to us. And that's what allowed everybody to buy in and be coachable. Obviously, you feel like you have greatness in yourself, but when you're playing with somebody that's really great, you get to really see greatness. I was a great basketball player. I had a great career. But standing on the side of guys like Tim Duncan, Reggie Miller, and Baron Davis, I really seen greatness. It made me level up. It helped me have a better career. And I learned how to be a professional from Reggie and Tim Duncan. So being around greatness is a plus in a lot of areas. And it's a blessing to be able to experience that in my career because a lot of guys don't. He gave me the title of the ultimate teammate. To get that from Tim Duncan, you know, he's never said he's played with Manu Ginobili, Tony Parker, Kawhi Leonard, Steve Kerr, Steve Smith. He's played with a lot of guys. For him to give me that title, I hold on to it. I cherish it because, you know, when you have a guy, like I said, the best power forward ever to win championships with so many guys, for him to call me the ultimate teammate, that means a lot to me because that means that I never put myself before my team. I'll do anything for any one of my teammates, and, you know, I hold on to that dearly, being the ultimate teammate coming from Tim Duncan.